Today's sponsor is Advancement Courses. Stay tuned at the end of the show for a special coupon for 20% off any of their grad-level professional development courses. Podcasting how-tos and tips with one of my favorite podcasters, Jeff Bradbury, episode 267.
The 10-Minute Teacher Podcast with Vicki Davis. Every weekday, you'll learn powerful, practical ways to be a more remarkable teacher today.
So teachers, today I'm talking with fellow podcaster and friend Jeff Bradbury from the Teachercast Network. And Jeff, you and I are both podcasters. And why did you start podcasting? I mean, what do you get out of it?
I love being able to reach out and work with teachers. We've been doing this for 7 years now, and it's been a great opportunity to not only meet people, but have people on the show and share their stories.
You know, I learn so much talking to people, and it's almost addictive, isn't it?
It absolutely is.
What keeps you doing the podcast?
Oh, you know, I get amazing feedback, not necessarily on the show, but on the things that we talk about. Just a quick story here. Many of you guys know that my wife is now in remission from breast cancer, and I recently put out, you know, kind of small stories on the show, and it was so amazing and so wonderful to get feedback saying, I'm glad your wife is doing okay. Please send her our best and send her our love. That is the feedback that I absolutely love hearing about the show. People that listen and, you know, they get what you're doing and they get that you are a family person first. I absolutely love my audience.
Isn't it hard sometimes adjusting from, you know, I mean, we both kind of feel like we're just regular educators, right?
Absolutely. And I've said, you know, we've done over 800 shows here. I've always said I've never once interviewed anybody. I've always just had amazing conversations with them.
What's one of your most amazing where you're like, oh, this is so awesome?
You know, one of my favorite shows was one that I didn't even know I was doing. This was 6 years ago or so. You know, we had Dan Callahan on from, and at that point in time, he was kind of working with the EdCamp Foundation. He's one of the founders. And we just did a show on what was EdCamp. And 6 months later, I got an email from this random person that says, hey, I just wanted to let you know, we're here at EdCamp Buffalo. And the reason we're here at EdCamp Buffalo is because I heard your show and it inspired me to create my own EdCamp. And now we've got a couple hundred people here. That's pretty awesome. And yeah. I love that story because you never know who's listening. And many people say, you know, well, what are your numbers? Well, it's not your numbers. It's who's listening and the impact that you have on them might be next week and it might be next year. But everything that we do has the opportunity to impact the world.
And it's about the students. I mean, I remember a Spanish teacher from the Northeast who sent me an email once and said that he was a new teacher. And not only did he thank me, but his students thanked me because he was so excited about teaching in the classroom now. And he just felt like he had a new life. When you get those emails, you kind of go, you know, I get to do this. Really? I get to love on kids every day and love my colleagues, and then I get to help other teachers fall in love again. It's just awesome.
It's pretty remarkable.
Okay, so you and I both self-produce our podcast, and I know that you've recently, you know, relaunched everything. Is it hard to put this into your weekday routine?
You know, the day's pretty simple, right? I go to work, I come home, and now I'm a dad of 4-year-old triplets, and they go to bed around 8 o'clock. And so after that is my family time with my wife or my teacher cast time here. We recently launched we completely rebranded, redid everything here. And the new website is amazing. I hope you guys have a chance to check out teachercast.net. It's just a matter of making sure that you've got time to do everything. And that was the whole idea of having the new website, is to provide myself with a resource that not only is going to knock your socks off when you see it, but also give me the time with my family that they deserve.
It's about routines and habits and something called batching. So I'm interviewing you and we're talking today. And I think you're my 6th or 7th interview today. So, you know, people say, well, how do you do it? Well, really 3 or 4 days a month, I'll sit down and interview 6 or 7. And there's just routines. And then you're right. It's about making the back end even more efficient. So always saying, how can we save time? How can we be more helpful? How can we be more useful, right?
Oh, absolutely. And I always preach, have templates ready, you know, make sure that your show notes follow a path, make sure that your intro follows a path. That way everybody can kind of keep on the same, beat.
And finding people to help you. Do you have some folks who help you on your show?
You know, we have our show on, well, it's currently on Tuesday, although I think we might be changing it, called our Tech Educator Show. I've got some great co-hosts on there. Somebody who was recently on your show, Dr. Sam Patterson.
Oh yeah. Sam.
He's, you know, we're kind of partners in crime on this. He's got the West Coast people. I've got the East Coast people here. It is important to have a nice team around you. That being said, everything you see on TeacherCast, from the recording, the editing, to the show notes, to the, I've been doing it strong by myself basically for 7 years, but I love doing it that way. I've tried outsourcing it, but I've gotten it down to, I can record an hour show and have it edited out in about 5 or 6 minutes and published within, you know, an hour and a half of hanging up. It's just, you do it so long. It's like teaching, right? Like you do it so long, you get into a rhythm, you're good to go.
Well, we've just been going a little over a year with the 10-minute teacher. So there's me, there's my husband, Kip, who is the producer. There's Dr. Lisa Durf, who sets all the appointments because I just can't keep it all organized. And Kimberly Mulford, who does the transcripts. And then Jim Beagley, who keeps the hackers and gremlins off of my site. I mean, it's just so much, it seems like. But, you know, educators, you can do it by yourself or you can do it with a team. It can be done either way, right, Jeff?
Absolutely. You know, you don't have to do it by yourself. It's just a matter of making sure that you always have your audience in mind. And it's always about what does your audience want to listen to. And so, you know, keep in mind of why we're doing this, and it's to make some great content and improve the lives of students worldwide.
Jeff, what's the worst thing about podcasting?
You know that you have to put a show out tomorrow or the next day and you don't have a guest yet to fit the spot, or you're doing a live show in 5 minutes and the power goes out and you've got a live audience waiting for you. I live in North Jersey up in the mountains, and I literally live on an island. When the power goes out, you're the last people that the power company comes to. So we've had that unfortunately a couple of times now where everyone's ready to go and I'm ready to go and then nothing.
So your show is live and then you turn it into a podcast, right?
I do one live show a week. On any given week, I could be putting out anywhere between 10 and 15 podcasts. Right now, like I said, when we relaunched, we actually have 9 shows online, plus my client shows that I do. I do a show for the New Jersey Educators Association, and I also do a show for Microsoft Education. And so I guess that's 11 shows total that I'm running simultaneously. So it's a very, very crazy thing, but I love doing it. And for me, it's the, can you do it? And I love being able to do it. And I love being able to help anybody. I mean, one of the things, if you go over to educationalpodcasting.tips, it's our new private Facebook group. You guys are welcome to come in and join us, but we've got a nice growing community there over at educationalpodcasting.tips. And, you know, every day we're doing tips and tricks and share your stories and share your favorite thises and thats. And it's a nice little community.
We have 30 seconds to wrap up. If somebody's thinking about starting their own podcast, what's your advice?
Call me. I love working with podcasters. I love working with teachers. And remember, it doesn't have to be anything huge, right? Like I do a lot of work with teachers who want to make shows or media content in their classrooms, just as much as I love working with people who want to make studios like we have here. Call me anytime, educationalpodcasting.tips. And of course, you can always reach out at TeacherCast.
Educators, we've talked about podcasting. I also will add to the show notes all the equipment that I use. And I know, Jeff, if you have a link to yours, he and I both use these ATR. I have a 2100 and you have a 2500 mic?
Yep, 2005 USB. They're fantastic microphones.
They are. And just really easy to use. I actually have two of them so that if I want to podcast with my students and bring my personal rig to school, I can do that. And you can get started. You can do your own podcasting. You can partner with others. There's lots of ways to do it. But I think here's the big thing is podcasting is so intimate to me. I listen to podcasts. I really love learning from podcasts. And the thing about it is we can customize our own radio now. And that's one of the things I love about it the most. So take a look in the show notes at the TeacherCast relaunch and all that Jeff Bradbury's doing. Jeff, thanks for coming on the show and thanks for being my friend.
Thanks so much for having me.
Need some great professional development? Today's sponsor, Advancement Courses, has more than 200 graduate-level online professional development courses for K-12 teachers. You can take these courses for continuing education, salary advancement, or recertification. And these courses have us teachers developing tangible resources to use in our classrooms immediately. Go now to advancementcourses.com/coolcat and use the code COOL20 at checkout to get 20% off any course. With this coupon, a 3 grad credit course is only $359. So go to advancementcourses.com/coolcat to learn more and use the coupon code COOL20. Never stop learning.
Thank you for listening to the 10 Minute Teacher Podcast. You can download the show notes and see the archive at coolcatteacher.com/podcast. Never stop learning.